Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today, let's learn the lesson, A Question of Trust by Victor Canning from Class 10 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. Don't forget to press the notification button so that you get notified whenever I post a video. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from Classes 10, 11 and 12 English. So now let's move on to the video. About the author, Victor Canning was a prolific British writer of novels and thrillers who flourished in the 1950s, 60s and 70s. He was personally reticent, writing no memoirs and giving relatively few newspaper interviews. Introduction. This story is about Horace Danby, a 50-year-old man. Everyone around him thinks he is a good and an honest man. He used to build locks and earn enough profit so that he could hire two helpers. He was sent to jail once about 15 years ago because he used to commit robberies every year. This time too, he was caught and there was a question of broken trust. Let's look at the summary. Horace Danby was an honest and good man. He was about 50 years old and a bachelor. He made locks. He was very successful in his business. He had engaged two assistants to help him. Though good and respectable, he was not completely honest. He loved rare and expensive books. For this purpose, he robbed a safe every year. He bought books secretly through an agent. He planned his work well before his theft. This time he had studied the house at the Shotover Grange for 2 weeks. He studied even the minutest thing about the house. The family was in London. Two servants who looked after the house had gone to the movies. He entered the house from behind the garden wall. He was able to get the details of the house from a magazine. There was a detailed description about the plan and each room of the house. The article even mentioned about a safe that was concealed behind a painting in the drawing room. He took the key from the kitchen door hook. He put on a pair of gloves and opened the door. He was always careful enough not to leave any fingerprints. He spoke politely to the dog. He cut off the wires of the burglar alarm. He arranged his tools carefully. There was a big flower pot on the table. The scent of the flower tickled his nose and so he sneezed repeatedly. He thought that his hay fever would hinder his work. He used a handkerchief to cover his face. Then he heard the voice of a young lady behind him. She was young, pretty and dressed in red. She advised him to cure his hay fever with a special treatment. She spoke kindly to him. She pretended to be the wife of the owner of that house. She said that she had come there suddenly because she needed her jewels to wear them at the party that night. Danby begged the lady to let him go home. He hated going to prison. He promised her that he would never rob her again. The young lady asked him to do one work for her. Then she would let him go. The burglar said that he would do anything gladly for her. The young lady said that she needed the jewels, but she had forgotten the number. Horace opened the safe and handed over the jewels to the young lady. He went out happily. On the noon of the third day, a policeman arrested Horace. He was arrested for the jewel robbery at Shotover Grange. He was arrested on the basis of his fingerprints left on the safe. He had opened the safe without wearing his gloves. Horace pleaded that the lady of the house herself had asked him to open the safe for her. Then, the real owner of the house appeared. She was a grey-haired, sharp-tongued woman of 60. She stated that Horace's story was nonsense. The young lady in red had decamped with the jewels while Horace was sent to prison. The lady in red was a real culprit and a burglar. She had outwitted him. No one believed Danby. He was sent to jail. Now he was the assistant librarian in the prison. He often thought of the charming young lady who was in the same profession as he was. He did not like the thought of honor among thieves. Question and answers. Question number 1. Why does Horace Danby steal every year? Answer. He used to steal a safe every year in a very systematic and planned manner. He used to steal enough to last him for 12 months and so that he could buy the rare and expensive books that he used to like through a secret agent. Question number 2. Who is the real culprit in the story? Answer. The real culprit in the story is the woman who pretended to be a family member of the Shotover Grange. She cleverly acted as a family member and made Horace believe that she had forgotten the passcode of the safe. Horace believed her, removed his gloves and opened the safe and gave her all the jewels that were inside the safe. She escaped with all the jewels. Question number 3. Horace Danby was a meticulous planner, but still he faltered. Where did he go wrong and why? Answer. He did not gather enough information about the real occupants. He gathered information about the tracks, wirings, gardens, servants, and even the dog's name. He even took out the information of the valuables inside the safe. Once he got into a problem, he could not even think properly and open the safe without wearing his gloves. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. If you really liked today's video, don't forget to share it and give your valuable comments. Please subscribe. Thank you for watching.